Hey guys, I'm coming to you from the home of the guy that built the monster lawn tractor. He had contacted me after seeing that video and told me to come over and check it out a little closer. So that's exactly what we're doing. And I know you guys really seem to like it, so I thought it was worth taking a look at, and he's gonna fire it up and maybe drive it around, that kind of thing too. So we'll take a quick peek here. And I know you saw a lot of this in the first video, but one thing we weren't able to see was this awesome paint job he's got on here. And you can see a friend of his did some custom airbrushing. Got that cobra on there, and then all the flames, as you can see. And then it's even, I don't know if I can catch it in the light, but it's even got some ghost snake skin on there as well. But we'll kind of go around here, see if we can pick up some of that. You can see it a little bit there on the running board. And then he carried that kind of, I guess they'd call that like an electric flame, wouldn't they?
Yeah, that's yeah. What I call it.
And he carried that all the way across the rear fender here with the cobras and everything. You can see more of that snakeskin effect there. But it's definitely an awesome looking machine. But Lloyd here is actually the one that built it. And you said you built it for a poker run they have over there?
Yeah, the poker run they have every year in Beckemeyer. Mm-hmm. And it's a benefit for the Heart Association.
Oh, cool.
And there's usually around 100 to 130 lawnmowers that show up.
Oh, wow.
And it's really something to see, because mm-hmm. everybody does just about everything imaginable.
Everybody's trying to top each other, mm-hmm. I guess. Yeah. But,
it's all for a good cause. And mm-hmm. I said, well, let's do something different.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's, and you said this is the first year you've had this out, right?
So. Yeah, in fact, last week was the first time I drove it.
Wow.
At the poker room.
That's pretty cool.
Right at the end of the line, you know, mm-hmm. as far as time goes, and having it ready.
You want to tell us a little bit about the setup here? Just like
okay.
What
well, the transaxle is a lawnmower transaxle. Mm-hmm. Basically, they call it, I call it a Peerless 820 series. It's got 1-inch axles, and it's basically found in larger lawn tractor, lawn garden lawnmowers.
Okay. And that's how many gears?
It's 6-speed.
6-speed, okay.
This particular one is a 6-speed. The rotors are the rear rotors off an 07 Taurus. Mm-hmm. The calipers are the rear calipers off an 02 Taurus.
Okay.
And to get everything to fit onto the 1-inch axle, the red piece in between mm-hmm. here is a the wheel hub off a wheel horse lawnmower.
Oh, all right. And that way you got the right bolt spacing. And
that
everything.
Way the bolt pattern was ended up being 4.5 on 5, cool. And that's what the, all the Taurus stuff was.
Oh, cool. Yeah, that's a nice setup.
The rims are off a Ford Ranger. They're kind of old, but they're mm-hmm. not the prettiest, but they were free.
Yeah.
So I used them.
They're as good as what I got on my truck, I tell you.
The tires are 3.5-inch Super Swampers.
Uh-huh.
Now, on the front end, the hubs yeah. are just trailer hubs.
Okay.
The spindles are 1-inch in diameter, grade 8 bolts.
Okay.
6-inch long. And it's basically just a simple kingpin, you know, front end setup.
Okay.
The rack and pinion is out of a golf cart. And that's how it steers.
Yeah. Oh, and here, go ahead and turn that, because I couldn't believe this. Sitting here on pavement without power steering, he's able to crank those 38.5-inch tires. I thought that was pretty awesome. Yeah.
And the steering wheel is homemade. Uh-huh. I made it.
Oh, you okay. You welded up the chain yourself. That's
yeah.
awesome.
Before I put the rotors on the vehicle, mm-hmm. I laid the rotors on the bench, wrapped the chain around it, and started welding.
Yeah.
Oh, and then cool. the risers, I use a little bit smaller chain.
Uh-huh.
But
that's a good idea.
Some people don't.
Yeah. Oh, that's just cool that you handmade it too, you know. I never even thought about that. That's pretty neat. This is a Kohler V-twin, right?
Yeah, it's a 20 horse Kohler V-twin.
20 horse.
It's all stock, mm-hmm. all governed, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, you said you
no
didn't.
No modifications.
It's not like you made it to go real fast or anything.
Yeah,
it was not,
I did not. It does have 6 speeds, and it probably is capable of doing 30 to 40 miles an hour mm-hmm. if it was in 6th gear.
Yeah, I wondered that, because with these tall tires, I would think that it'd be geared where it could really roll pretty good if you were that gutsy, I guess. But
yeah, I'm not that gutsy. Yeah. But I didn't build it for speed.
Right.
I built it for fun. And,
oh, yeah,
and
no.
But,
oh, yeah, and then. Of course, I showed this, but we can show it again. You got a nice Wilwood master cylinder on here. Yeah, that's really cool.
But it's more than, it will definitely more than stop this thing.
Then do you put some like bed liner material on there?
Bed liner.
Okay.
We spray that at work.
All right. Yeah, that's pretty cool. So can you fire it up? We'll just see what it sounds like.
Sure. Yeah. Let me shut the hood. And then I put strobe lights on it.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'll tell you what. The red lights made me think of Gravedigger, the monster truck. Yeah.
It's hard to see it when it's facing the sun, but when you turn it on.
Oh, yeah.
And then I can, this little control box on the dash, I can speed them up or slow them down.
Oh, cool.
Or, make them go intermittent or what have you. But just something to play with.
Oh, yeah. That's awesome.
Let's see. Let's get it to neutral.
All right,
here we go.
Oh, wow. Man, that sounds good. That's why I like those V-twins, because it does have that kind of almost Harley kind of sound to it, you know?
Yeah, it's just straight, dual exhaust pipe.
Yeah.
No muffler or anything.
Man, that sounds good.
One of the biggest questions people, or most questions people ask is, how you get up on that thing?
Mm-hmm.
Let's find out.
Yeah, all right. Oh, there you go.
Climb the tire.
Built-in steps. Man, you do sit up there, that's for sure.
I can clean my gutters.
No kidding. I mean, you got to be like 8.5 feet in the air or something.
When I first climbed on this thing, it almost scared me.
Mm-hmm.
It is a little intimidating until you get used to it.
You want to drive around the yard a little bit? We'll just see it move.
Sure.
Look out. Yeah, it sounds good.
Wow.
Yeah, that thing is cool. I like it even more now. It's good. It sounds awesome. Yeah, it's taller than my car by a long way. But yeah, that thing's cool. Man, that thing is awesome. It's even cooler when you see it moving, you know?
That's basically it, guys.
All right.
Bye.
Yeah, I'm sure it's going to... After they see this, then you're going to have other people wanting to do it, I'm sure. Yeah.
I mean, there ain't nobody I've found yet that hasn't liked it.
Yeah, that thing is cool. Well, thanks a lot, Lloyd, for showing us all that.
Anytime.
And I know people found it really interesting. So, anyway, guys, thanks for watching and commenting and everything. We really appreciate it. And I'll see you later. Bye.